My name is Tracy Strauss, and I am the founder and artistic director of Celebrate the Beat. Yay! Thank you. And at Celebrate the Beat, we believe that every child has a powerful beat within, and it is our work to help them to find it, feel it, hear it, express it, and celebrate it, so that they can be enhanced by it in every aspect of their lives. So you know, you're part of our in-school community. We go into the schools, we work with the children. And in the summer, we have our six-week summer institute. Before I tell you about what we've been doing, I want to thank the musicians for making that change there. A huge thank you to Javier. Can you wave, Javier? He's kept the space clean and beautiful. And his partner, Nick. And Principal Tom Kiolik. Hello. Welcome. You can have a seat right there. Perfect. Guest yoga instructor, Jennifer Panza. Parent volunteers, Louise and Karen. And all of you for lending us your children. Thank you. So for 6 weeks, every single day, we've started with a yoga practice. All the mats, all 60 mats, were donated by different studios all over Denver. We were given yoga clothing and dance clothing by Allie Kramer and Allison Ricciardo D'Agostino. After ballet, after yoga, we moved into ballet. I'm getting excited, Pat. I'm getting ahead of myself because I have so much to say because it's been such an incredible summer. So for ballet, we were gifted ballet slippers for 60 children. And the owner of Boulder Bodywear, Amy, came and fitted each foot. After ballet, we engaged in a beautiful contemporary dance class led by Bashir. Can you wave, Bashir? Thank you, Bashir. And that made us very hungry. And so then we had lunch, and lunch was provided by the Food Bank of the Rockies and Revolution Food. And we're so grateful for these beautiful partnerships. And it is those partnerships that nurture our children and make them the best that they can be. And you're going to be blown away by what you're going to see. After lunch, we engaged in a deep dive into curriculum, learning about the heroes who inform our theme of We Persist. Now, all of this is led by the most amazing small but mighty gal, Denver Program Director Heather Kratz. Could you please stand up? And supported by the best staff in the world. J.J. O'Dell, will you please stand up? Thank you. Emma Stedman, give us a wave. All the way from Mexico, the gal who leads our Mexico program so incredibly. Colleen McCumber, will you please wave? Joel Fadness on the drums. Oh, so I have to tell you, these guys, they're with us every single day, 6 weeks, every single day. They go back and forth. They play every instrument under the sun. So I said drums because Joel's usually on the drums, but today he's on the piano. It's very hard to keep track. Anyway, today, Joel Fadden is on the keys. Patrick Padgett, our beloved music director, on the drums. And a gorgeous guest singer with us, Cheryl Renee. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce you to the Adams 14 All-Star! Thank you. first story we're going to tell takes place in 1899, when the youth came together. If you're in the doorway, join us. Come in, Teddy, my friend. Come in, come in. You're so far. Come, come, come. Teddy. Teddy is an amazing friend. You have a front row seat, Teddy. Come on in. So, back to 1899. The newsboys, a lot of them homeless, selling newspapers, got word that their boss said they were going to get a cut in pay. Well, the boys, in this case, girls too, band together to stand up for what they believed was right. We bring you the Newsies.
Sure, beats washing dishes. What a fine life. Carrying the banner home for all.
The Newsboy Strike of 1899 was a youth-led union campaign to force change. The first kids' strike to ever come to an agreement, the Newsies made history. But it didn't come without a fight.
This is the story we needed to write, and we're kept out of sight, well, no more. In a few hours, by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight us a war. This is the time we were itched to stay, talk about seizing the day. This time the union awaits, once and for all.
Invited from the elementary and middle and high schools right here in Adams 14 in Commerce City. They have dedicated their summer to coming here for 6 weeks, 9:30 to 3:30, Monday through Thursday. That is commitment, that is dedication, that is passion. Give them a hand. And it has been such an honor and a pleasure to share with them the theme of We Persist, celebrating heroes from around the world, doctors, scientists, nurses, singers, poets, artists, athletes, who have followed their dreams, who have believed in something and took a step and made a change. And right now, I would like to introduce you to two of our dedicated, passionate, and committed dancers, Abby Tech and Luis Suarez. Dancing a piece choreographed by Chris Stoffer, who is not here, and Bashir Page Sanders.
I can change the world with my own two hands, make it a better place. With my own two hands, make it a kinder place. With my own two hands, my own with my own two hands. I can make peace on earth with my own two hands. I can clean up the earth with my own two hands. I can reach out to you with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands. I'm gonna make it a brighter place with my own two hands. I'm gonna make it a safer place with my own two hands. I'm gonna help the human race with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands.
Freedom. Education, equality, the environment are all issues that the heroes we celebrate here today have stood up and fought for. No matter the challenge presented, they persisted.
Hold on to me, don't let go. Jesus need to eat, run and look. La 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 la. Your first name is King, last name is Dumb, 'cause you still believe in everyone. Freedom, 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 freedom.
Accompanied by a professional live musician. These musicians arrange music, write music, put together bands, and create amazing performances like you're witnessing today. Joel Fadness and Patrick Padgett created an arrangement based on a pop song by Britt Nicole called Be the Change. It's arranged for soloists, a chorus, and bucket drummers. Watch as these dancers be the change.
Five, six, here we go.
Hey, 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 hey,
Mandela was a great man who fought against apartheid in South Africa. He was imprisoned for 27 years because of his activism fighting for equality. During his time behind bars, Nelson Mandela did not give up. He stood up for what he believed in. He even refused two opportunities for freedom, but instead stuck by his principles. Once released from prison, he became South Africa's first black president. He worked hard to make his country a place of equality, where people of all race and all colors lived in peace. Nelson Mandela persisted.
Introduce myself, introduce our lovely students that are going to say some narration. I'm Colleen and I run the Mexico program, and this is Bashir. Right here we have Hail Mary and we have Lorenzo. For me, this next piece is pretty important, and I think there's no better time than today to celebrate that our country was founded on immigrants. And para mí, el tiempo es hoy, es ahorita, por celebrando los Estados Unidos y el fundación es son con, ay, perdón, es con los inmigrantes.
Nearly all Americans have ancestors who braved the oceans, liberty-loving risk-takers in search of an ideal, the largest voluntary migrations in recorded history. Across the Pacific, across the Atlantic, they came from every point on the compass, many passing beneath the Statue of Liberty. Immigration is not just a link to America's past, it is also a bridge to America's future.
Casi toda la gente de Estados Unidos tienen ancestros que se enfrentaron a los oceánicos que amarán a los que aman la libertad en busca de una inmigración voluntaria ideal. La mayor es la historia registrada al otro lado del Pacífico, al otro lado del Atlántico. Vinieron de todas las de todos los puntos de la brújula, muchos pasando por debajo de la Estatua de la Libertad. La inmigración no es solo un vínculo con el pasado de Estados Unidos, también es un puente hacia el futuro de Estados Unidos.
You can clap for them. So the next piece that you're going to see is a celebration of all immigrants that make up the fabric of the U.S. Ólafur Amadz is the Iceland composer of the music, and the song is called Happiness Does Not Wait. The poem spoken, Things We Carry by the Sea, is by Wong Ping. We are a nation of immigrants.
Esta siguiente fiesta de baile es una celebración de todos los inmigrantes de los Estados Unidos. Ólafur Arnalds, de Islandia, es el compositor de la música y la canción se llama La Felicidad No Espera. El poema hablando es Cosas que Llevamos en el Mar, de Wong Ping. Somos una nación de inmigrantes.
We carry tears in our eyes. Goodbye, mother. Goodbye, father. We carry soil in small bags. May home never fade in our hearts. We carry names, stories, memories of our villages, fields, boats. We carry scars of proxy, wars of greed.
We carry carnage of mining, droughts, floods, genocides. We carry dust of our families and neighbors incinerated in mushroom clouds. We carry our islands sinking under the sea. We carry our hands, feet, bones, hearts, and best minds for a new life.
We carry diplomas of medicine, engineer, nurse, education, math, poetry, even if they mean nothing to the other shore.
We carry railroads, plantations, laundromats, bodegas, farms, factories, hospitals, schools, built on our ancestors' backs.
We carry old homes along the spine, new dreams in our chest.
We carry yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
We're orphans of the war forced upon us.
We're refugees of the sea rising from industrial wastes. And
we carry our mother's tongues.
I, Hub,
Labi, Amor, Love,
King Nam, Salam,
Shalom, Paz, Peace,
Kiswang, Amor, Hofingnyang, Esperanza,
Hope, Hope, Hope.
As we drift in our boats from shore
to shore
to shore.
Thank you.
So for this next piece, we want to take you in to one of our classes. We want to show you the teaching techniques we use in Celebrate the Beat. We have the next piece that's called the We Persist Fact Dance. I need an assistant to help me. Juliet? Judith! Judith, come on out here. So these are our fact cards. W represents what?
Women's right to vote.
Women's right to vote. What amendment was that and what year?
19th Amendment.
And what year?
1920.
1920. Then we have E for we persist. Since E happens twice, E represents two things. What does the first E represent?
Education.
Education, and who stood up to the Taliban and fought for the right for girls to go to school?
Malala.
Malala. And then E represents the United States' first, one of the first, besides the Newsies, child group of child activists to fight for their environment. What group is that called?
Earth Guardians.
The Earth Guardians. Take it away, Miss Judith, and show W plus E. Ready, steady, here she goes. Give it up. And then we're gonna move forward and skip to the last two letters in We Persist. S happens twice, so S represents what?
Albert Einstein.
S represents what word? No, it's all good.
Science.
Science, scientist. What is the first scientist that we're celebrating?
Albert Einstein.
Albert Einstein. What was the equation in his law of relativity?
E equals mc squared.
E equals mc squared. Then the second S represent what female scientist?
Marie Curie.
Marie Curie. She was the first woman to not win one, but two.
Nobel Peace Prizes.
Nobel Peace Prizes. And what were the two elements that she added to the periodic table?
Polonium and radium.
Polonium. Can you tell the audience what is the root of calling it polonium?
Her country home, Poland.
She was from Poland. And then letter T represents what female?
Harriet Tubman.
Harriet Tubman, who helped free over 300 slaves through the Underground Railroad. Here is our T fact card. All right, take it away. Show us S plus T. Ready, steady, here she goes. Thank you so much, Judith. Also, another T that we talked about was from the Tao, from China. An old ancient poem states, "Water is soft and flexible, yet possesses an immense power to overcome obstacles and alter landscapes, even carving canyons with its slow and steady persistence." Dancers, take it away with We Persist.
People, keep on learning. Soldiers, keep on warring. Keep on turning, 'cause it won't be too long. Powers, keep on lying, while your people keep on dying. Keep on turning. I'm so darn glad he let me try it again. 'Cause my last time on earth I lived the whole world a sin. I'm so glad that I know more than I do then. Gonna keep on trying till I reach the higher ground. Teachers, keep on teaching. Keep on preaching. World, keep on turning, 'cause it won't be too long.
Wow. I'm speechless, and so I'm going to invite one of our beautiful dancers to share with you what Celebrate the Beat means to her, Abby.
So I've actually been doing Celebrate the Beat for 6 years. And over the years, it's just changed my life in so many positive ways. It's made me more confident. It's given me the ability to make friends. And it's just made me really happy in general. And last year, I actually took a year off. And when I came back, I just realized that I never want to stop being a part of just this family that we make and stop dancing in general. And I just want to thank all my teachers and all the dancers around me for helping us be a team and shining our light together.
So some of the dancers we've worked with since they were in third grade, and now they're in high school, and so they become assistants for us, and they continue with us, and they learn new skills of mentorship. And our program is enormous here, just in Adams 14, and then we're in Eagle County, and we're in Mexico. And we're related to what we call the mothership, National Dance Institute in New York City. Sorry, my back is to you. So at New York City, 43 years ago, started this incredible company. A man named Jacques d'Amboise, he had a vision that all children should be transformed by art, that it moves us so beautifully. And this summer, we got to learn a piece of choreography that was choreographed by the artistic director of National Dance Institute in New York City, Ellen Weinstein, and it is a tribute to the most fierce, amazing artist who stood for respect, for the power of positive thinking, for believing in making positive change. Lady Soul, Aretha Franklin!
Respect.
So we're a team of five, consisting of our manager and our four people who actually cook. A manager keeps us in line. She's the one that says, oh, you need to speed up. You're on time. You're ahead of time. She's the one that actually keeps us all together.